Hi guys, and welcome back to the official Simple Minds Tour Diary. Today we are here in beautiful sunny Eindhoven, which is in the south of Holland. And in this episode, I'm going to be talking to the legend that is Gordy Gowdy. Let's go. When did you first start playing music?
I remember when I was a little kid, and my mum used to always play the radio in the kitchen, and I heard the first chord of a Beatles, It's a Hard Day's Night. And I always remember the sound of it. And I remember saying to my mother, what is that, man? And she's like, oh, that's a guitar. So that's the thing that probably turned me on. And from that point on, I was always aware of music. And I sort of tuned into it. My uncle was a violin player, and we had a violin in the house. So my dad sent me to my uncle Danny. Well, he used to live at the back of the race course.
Oh, right.
So he always had a bet on, and he only ever listened to Frank Sinatra and checked the results, the horse racing results. So yeah, that was my first experience. I kind of learned to play the violin. The guitar, I don't know, maybe 14, I think it was about 14. I had a band with my brother and my little brother. We were a sort of punk band because it was the heady days of punk rock. My first ever gig. Might have been the Stranglers, actually, to tell you the truth. At the Apollo. And there was a guy with a dead rat round his neck, and I always remember that. But I mean, the first record I ever bought was like a David Bowie, Aladdin Sane. That's the first album, and I liked T-Rex. It was sort of glam rock at that point. When it came to making music, you know, obviously the punk thing was happening, and that was my time. Then after that, I played with Echo and the Bunnymen for 14 years. Actually, one of the first gigs I probably did see was the Simple Minds. And it was a place where I grew up in a town called Ayr. And it was a place called The Pavilion. Jim was always a really great, great front man, you know what I mean? And he had the eyeline on the bowl haircut, and he looked kind of mysterious. And you were quite scared of him a little bit, you know what I mean? They were theatrical. It was quite a theatrical thing, but they just had a great sound, you know what I mean? The band were great. They had a great groove, and they were modern. You know, they were cutting edge, you know what I mean? They were like trying to do something. They were the future, if you like, as opposed to just doing the same old rehashes of rock songs or whatever, you know what I mean? It sounded futuristic, and I liked that. Because all music has to move on, everything has to progress. I can't remember how, but I met Jim and Charlie, it was probably about 20 years ago, I'm not really good with dates, and it was a studio called The Farm, which was kind of outside of Glasgow. And I met Jim and Charlie there, and we embarked on recording some music together. Music's like drugs without taking the drug. Because music can do that thing to me and take my head into that space.
Ha 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 ha.